Nepal is one of the unique countries. We have landscape, sea level to world highest mountain here. Our mountains are always standing to welcome people from all over the world.
Nepal is a very beautiful country, to be very honest. It's beautiful in a sense of diversity, it's beautiful in sense of belongingness, beautiful in terms of geography.
My experience coming to Nepal has been amazing. They're just the most humble, kind, welcoming people that I've ever associated with.
I love Nepal. I've been very impressed as I've watched the people here, and it's been very inspiring to see the sense of community and family.
The thing I'm most impressed with is the warmth and the genuine interest in trying to help other people.
You realize that it's not all just about you. It's about the community, it's about God, it's about people around you.
We have major issues like the environmental problems, pollution issues.
Pollution level is very high, especially in the Kathmandu Valley. Due to the topographical condition, the pollutant will be trapped in the air over the 24 hours.
We're here in Nepal working with a population of brick workers. Brick manufacturing is a very old occupation in Nepal. It has a strong cultural history. Many of the buildings and temples in Nepal are made of bricks. But with the manufacturing of bricks, there are some serious environmental and occupational health consequences.
PM 2.5, which is particulate matter, there's a lot of that in the air. We're looking at that and silica dust. Bricks contain silica, and that's really harmful to your lungs.
The conditions that a lot of Nepalese brick workers are working in are 3 to 5 times worse than the conditions accepted in the United States. They can develop lung conditions like silicosis, COPD issues. They also cook inside their homes, which releases more particles into the air through combustion. A lot of workers here are exposed to bad conditions at work and at home when it comes to the air they're breathing.
The main reason that we're here in Nepal now is to collect data to help us to be better informed for future efforts to make changes.
The idea is to build an interdisciplinary team that can investigate the problem in its totality so that we can then find sustainable solutions.
In addition to scores of students that are on site, we've managed a multi-institutional collaboration. Brigham Young University is well represented, as well as collaborators at the University of Utah, but also local collaborators. University of Kathmandu and others are on site and helping us really put this big picture together.
The process that we're doing here includes several steps. First, our station, we get a questionnaire to make sure we understand how they live in these conditions.
We do blood pressure, body fat percentage, we take their height and their weight, hand grip strength, pulse oximeter, so their blood oxygen.
As part of the nursing side, we are getting saliva samples, a blood draw, and an ultrasound that is going to help us get a better picture of what's going on with the respiratory health of the kiln workers here.
Our monitoring is of the individual breathing zone. It's to simulate what the worker will actually be breathing in as they go throughout their day-to-day lives. But we also monitor the air quality of their homes.
I'm looking at water and air and soil. I'm doing kind of a more broad look at what it's looking like in the community rather than just the brick kiln.
This research is so important. It's amazing to get data that paints such a complete picture. This can help us really educate people and can really help us make a difference in their lives.
If there's something that we can do to help people, that's what I want to do. I want to be part of that. And this is only the beginning.
I'm enthusiastic and I'm very happy to work with BYU. With this collaboration, we can do many more things. And I expect this collaboration will go for many years.
One thing I found with this group, they are very sincere you know, students, they don't drink, they don't smoke, you know. They are very good attitude. So that's why I really love this team. The manner, you know, is very, very high level. This is much different than others.
It's really inspiring to think that there's people trying to do good all over the world.
I don't know that I've ever seen my students so happy and so engaged in learning. And as a professor, it's been incredibly rewarding to me to just sit back and listen to them talk about the experiences that they're having here and their love for the people, their desire to use the science to make the world a better place.
Our students really care. They care for what they're doing. They care for the people here in Nepal. And they show that, and the people feel that. And the people are just in love with our students.
We're all a human family, and we're all interconnected. And the things that I do to try and improve upon myself, my education, the ways in which I try to treat people, it matters, and it has ripple effects even 8,000 miles away in Nepal. You can change the lives of other people for the better if you're just willing to use the gifts and experiences which God has blessed you with.